I think the impact that it's had is pretty catastrophic. It's basically leaving a path of destruction that's equivalent to the crack epidemic. You know, it pretty much picked up where the crack epidemic left off and just continued this path of destruction. You know, and I've had a different view than a lot of people of the direct impact that it's having on the youth, because of course it's no secret I've done time in prison. And especially the last time in prison, you know, listening to these young cats that was in there, you know, I can see that it was a direct result, you know, from the music that they were listening to, you know. Because, I mean, you got to think, back in the golden era when we were listening to the positive hip-hop, everybody had a positive attitude. You know, they were wearing the African medallions, the leather medallions and all that. And then it switched to gold chains, you know. And then, you know, cats like Jay-Z up the ante to platinum, you know, and drinking, you know, $200 bottles of champagne. And these kids that's, you know, that I was in prison with, you can tell they was listening to this music and they was actually trying to live that life. You know, I mean, just recently, I think it was in the New York Times, they ran a spread on Jay-Z bragging, you know, about how he was a crack dealer. So, you know, though crack isn't, you know, as big as it was back in the 80s and then the 90s, you know, you got to think these kids are reading this. They're very impressionable. They're listening to the music of how he hustled. You know, all the other rappers that talk about hustling and gang banging, and they think that that's a way to make it, you know, and they end up in prison, you know. So I really seen the direct effect that this music that they're, you know, force feeding everyone, you know, the effects that it's having on the youth, you know. And then it goes a little bit deeper, as you know, these record companies that are pushing this type of music, and you know, a lot of them have invested in the prison industrial complex, mainly the private prison industry, you know. So of course they need these prisons filled, and of course there's a lot of talk, hearsay, whatever they call them, conspiracy theories of how these corporate heads got together and said, look, if we program, you know, everybody with this type of music, you know, we're sure to have, you know, filled up prisons, and filled up prisons means, of course, profit. So it's definitely a bigger impact than a lot of people, you know, are really, really, you know, grasping, you know. I've gotten to debates and people say, well, it's the parents, they need to be on their children, it's their responsibility. But, you know, the parents aren't there all the time. You know, they're forced to work sometimes two jobs if it's a single mom. If it's both parents got to work. So it's a social responsibility, you know. So you have all these rappers selling out for a couple of million dollars, you know, and they'll say whatever they're told to say, you know. And I've definitely sat in offices of, you know, record executives and, you know, playing my music, and they asked me directly, oh man, we have this one, you know, opportunity, if you can maybe, you know, do a little bit of the gangster stuff, you know. And I was just like, you gotta be kidding me. So I wouldn't do it. It's just, it wasn't me. And I mean, even at that time, I was still a member of a gang, and I wouldn't do it. So I came into hip-hop, you know, early on. I mean, the first rap song I ever listened to that got me into hip hop was The Message, you know, and it really meant something to me. I loved the party jams before The Message, but The Message had a really, really hard impact on me, and it stuck with me. So that's why all my music, just about all my music, has a message. Thank you.
That one person, you. But come on, I wanna see everybody put a fist up, as I'm about to baptize y'all into the revolution. Come on, everybody put a fist up and repeat after me. Come on,
say I am
a revolutionary.
A revolutionary.
I am a revolutionary.
A revolutionary.
I am a revolutionary.
A revolutionary. They arrest us for nothing, man, I'm ready to do something. The prison industry and the corporate hustle need to be dismantled as we continue to struggle. Open up your eyes, you're living in a bubble. The country you adapt for is real quick to fuck you. I reach out to touch you, a revolutionary sound. When I die, leave more deserved souls than a hope in the ground. Wanna leave them liberated, free from oppression, free from oppression. Wars and racism, I'll put a bullet in your brain if it'll make any difference in dismantling colonialists and imperialists. Wanna see every politician rotting in prison. That's not a mission statement, that's my fucking mission. Say I am. A dying in a cage, and fuck the American dream, it was these well-earned wages. Fuck Kennedy's speech, trying to make a sucker pay, so we went from chattel slavery to economical enslavement. They take our right to bear arms, leaving us hopeless. That's all our people are slaves at any given moment. Our system is broken, I speak for the unspoken, for every grieving mother and death penalty opponent. It's genocide and slaughter of our sons and daughters. Guns are in order, guerrillas without borders. I'm old school, so fuck a newer order. What I spit will bless the kids just like Coach Border. I stand against oppressors with the mic in a shank, cause I would rather die free than have a dime in a bank. Fuck a Benz, fuck a Bentley, fuck an MTV crib. I'm tired of living how people tell me to live. See, enemy appointed attorneys, guilty or innocent, they show you no mercy. It's constitutional if you're convicted by jury. You think it's justice to your firstborns on the gurney. Thousands executed, there'll be thousands more. Those being executed, brown and poor. I'm declaring war on the fascist bastards. When it's prison against God, like it was slave against master. Being captured is not an option. Political imprisonment, I won't be silenced. I'm a product of my environment, so go out violent. Fucking a prison riot. From Joplin to Elmira, for the juvenile lifers, wanna be lifers. Tell me how much more could anybody be Christ-like? The lethal injection, minor dangerous evictions. What has been, what have I seen, and now the murder convictions. See, I've been working my ass off, trying to move this struggle from a low to a high level. I've been traveling all over the world, seeking out real soldiers that are down to fight against corruption. Can see fascism already exists in America and elsewhere, and I can see the glass coming in the near future. So I'm working hard to put together a worldwide